Hello, my name is Shane Mitchell, and I want TYT to do more good, solid science stories. Or, more specifically, I want to do good, solid science stories for TYT. Our first story comes from the world of medical science. At a meeting of the American Chemical Society, researchers presented a new way to test for salmonella using gold nanoparticles. They'll cut the required testing time from 17 hours to 5 minutes. The test can be done to test for salmonella as well as E. coli, and the nanoparticles will be used to test for contaminated food and water here in the States as well as developing countries. Gold nanoparticles, in case you didn't know, are extremely small. If you strung 25,000 of them together, they'd be the same width as a single human hair. So even though they're made of gold, to make a few gallons of the solution would only cost around $90. And only a few drops of this stuff is needed to test for bacteria. Pretty cool, huh? The way it works is the gold nanoparticles have antibodies attached to them, so when they encounter the bacteria, the antibodies attach to the bacteria, and the gold particles find their way into the bacteria. Since the gold particles are so small, a lot of them will make it inside each piece of bacteria. Then a simple test is performed to see if the gold found any salmonella. The great thing is the test is something that can be done easily on a farm or in a remote area in developing countries. Dr. Parish C. Ray, who led the research, explained that the test fulfills an urgent need for a faster way to detect salmonella, especially the multiple drug-resistant strains that cause the most serious diseases in both food and drinking water. Dr. Ray said that the technology can be commercialized and that the patent is still currently pending. Currently, all tests have shown no toxicity as a result of the gold nanoparticles, but the researchers will continue to test for possible long-term effects. If this research leads to something that companies can use to test their foods, they will. Super cheap testing for salmonella and E. coli? It's a no-brainer. Our second story is also a medical science story. In a study published in the Journal of the American Chemical Society, a team of researchers have developed a way to test immune cell responses under specific conditions using gold nanoparticles. They're quite useful, those gold nanoparticles, huh? Since the immune system ignores these gold nanoparticles, the researchers are able to coat the particles with various chemical residues to test how immune cells respond. The reason why this is important is because there's much about immune cell responses we don't know about. Well, let me explain something first. Medications need to escape detection from the immune system in order to do what they need to do. While vaccinations need to do the opposite. They need to be taken in so the immune system can create protective antibodies. Using this technique, scientists will be able to test various compounds and other relevant things so they get a much clearer idea of how to accommodate the immune system responses to drugs and the like. Dr. Dan Peer, who headed the study, said that we are using these gold particles to tackle the question of how the immune system recognizes different particles, which might include features such as geometry, charge, curvature, and so much more. Now that we know the tool works, we can build on it. What this means is that basically a lot less guesswork will have to be done when it comes to how drugs will interact with the immune system. This will lead to much better treatments and drugs. Our last story is medical science as well. According to a new study in circulation research, researchers have found a way to detect inflammation in artery plaque deposits using radioactive antibody fragments. The study's lead author, Dr. Alexis Brossat, said that the detection of vulnerable coronary plaque is a major clinical challenge because it would allow preventative patient management prior to a heart attack. Currently, there is no early, reliable, and non-invasive way of doing so. This technique would allow physicians to inject nanobodies into the body and scan for particles in artery plaque called vascular cell adhesion molecule 1. This molecule plays a crucial role in the inflammation of plaque deposits, which leads to ruptured plaque, which leads to heart attacks. This is huge. It would allow you to get tested early for heart attack risk and have it a lot more precisely done. Now the bad news. The technique has not been approved for human use, and has only been tested on mice. However, the results are very promising, as the nanobodies remain stable in the laboratory and in the mouse blood for 6 hours. Before human trials can begin, however, researchers will have to conduct toxicology studies and produce clinical quality materials that show that the radioactive nanobody technique is safe, effective, and cost-efficient. Well, that's all the stories for today, and tomorrow I will be doing some stories that are not medical science stories, but still fun all the same.